I've got a lot to talk about, but today I'm just gonna touch on having a big family. As you probably know, I have a pretty big family. I have 5 daughters, and whenever I'm with them in public, people just seem to think that that's a free pass to tell me whatever they're thinking. A lot of times people will say things like, "Wow, you have a big family. Are they all girls? Still trying for that boy?" Sometimes people are like, "Are those kids all yours?" And I'll just be like, "Nah, I just needed a couple extra hands to help me carry all these groceries." At first it didn't bother me at all. It really still doesn't bother me, but since it's been going on now for a long time, it seems like it's starting to feel a little sexist. I do have 5 girls, and usually people are like, "Do you want to keep trying for a boy? Or can't get your boy?" That's not exactly the only reason I'm having kids. Like, I'm super happy that I have 5 beautiful, healthy little girls, and they mean the world to me, and that's really amazing for me. So when people say, "Still trying for your boy," I kind of feel like it's not, like, they're not saying it to be mean or like hateful, but it's just kind of conditioned so that people assume you're going for a boy. All right, so quick little story time. The other day I was at Ross with Gracelyn and Gretchen. They are 9 and 4, and this guy is looking at cleats where I'm looking over at shoes there, and he goes, "Oh, are those your girls?" And I was like, "Yeah, I actually have 5 daughters." And he goes, "Oh man, I'm so sorry." And then the best thing ever happened. Gretchen, who as I mentioned is 4, looks at him and says, "Actually, my dad is very happy." Oh, burn! And I didn't say anything else to the guy. I just gave him the old, "Yeah, maybe that's what's up. Maybe it's all about the girls, man." So I don't know, it was awesome. And the thing is, they hear it. You know, whenever I'm out and they're like, "Oh, still going for your boy," like, my daughters hear that. I always reinforce how amazing they are. People think it's just kind of an icebreaker or something, but when I see somebody by themselves with no children, I don't just go up to him and be like, "Oh, you better get going on those children." That'd be crazy. You don't just walk up to someone based on how many children they have around them and engage them in conversation. But you guys with big families know it's just like open season on big families. It's big time open season on big families. And it's fun. Once again, most people, absolutely, I never take offense to it. I don't think people actually mean any harm. But like I said, when it happens over and over and over again, and your daughters hear it over and over again about, "Hey, still going for that boy?" It's like, "No, going for healthy, happy children. Nailed it, 5 in a row. Everybody's super awesome." I think it's really great to have a big family. I had 2 brothers and a sister, and it really teaches you to share. It teaches you how to communicate. It teaches you to play well with others. I think it's great that I have all girls. They always have somebody to play with. They always have hand-me-down clothes coming their way. They always have someone to help them tie their shoes. They always have someone to help them brush their teeth. And I pretty much don't have to do anything at all, no. But I mean, it's really cool, right? I mean, they have constant friends, and I let them know how important sisters are. I let them know that their friendship and their bond with their sister is unlike any relationship that they're ever gonna have in their whole life. And as a child, you don't really appreciate that. My brothers and I are really, really super close. And I wouldn't trade that relationship and that friendship and growing up with them, I wouldn't trade that for anything. Do you have a pretty big family? What do people say to you? There's gotta be something that you've heard a lot, or it drives you crazy, or you think it's funny. Whatever it is, let me know in the comments below, and I'll definitely do a follow-up to this video, and I'll talk about what you have to say. I feel like since we have a big family, we always prefer to host events. So we always invite friends to come to our house for dinner, for movies, for poker night, for whatever event is, because it's a really quite the performance to get everybody dressed and packed up and in the car and get the babies. I mean, especially with Gemma being 8 months, you know, get the baby, she's a whole dance all by herself. You know, you gotta get her all in the car seat and get her diaper bag and get all that going on versus just have people over. Yeah, you have to clean up, but you don't have everybody getting in and out of the car. I mean, sometimes when we're going on errands or going somewhere, I'll just skip things because it's just so much to get in and out of the car. I know it sounds ridiculous. In and out of the car is simple, but when there's little ones and a baby, and I will say, even though the baby weighs like 20 pounds, I swear when she's in the car seat, and she's letting you know right now, she's waking up, when she's in the car seat, she's gotta weigh 50 pounds. That car seat, on its own. I don't know how that happens. I don't know how it gets so much heavier, but it's crazy how heavy that thing gets carrying that thing around. All right, guys, sounds like somebody woke up. So that's gonna be it for now. Don't forget, follow the rule, stay golden. See you guys soon, bye.